Okay. Now, as well as living in Ohio, I also live 6 months out of the year in Los Angeles, trying to do the television, movie, theater thing, you know, right? Only I forgot I was a lesbian. And because, you know, you can have lesbians on TV, they just can't be played by lesbians, so. Yeah. I forgot to know that. Doing really well, though. I haven't had too much trouble. I did have one sort of homophobic moment when I went for an audition. I auditioned for a small part. Oh, nothing. Audition for the part. Come home, my agent calls. Casting director says, well, she's okay. We're not going to use her. She's just a little too dykey. Oh, you know, I can't get real lesbians to think I'm a dyke. So there I am in Los Angeles. You know, I have a home with furniture and stuff. I didn't want to buy all new furniture, so I rented a totally furnished apartment from a gay guy. I have the most amazing furniture. So strange. But you know, it's really weird. He took all the lamps. And I noticed it, you know, later that evening. It's freaking dark in here. So to go buy lamps, so I went to this place, IKEA. Do you know IKEA, the furniture store? Well, if you've ever been there, then you know, every single thing you buy in IKEA, you have to put together yourself. I don't care if you get a spatula. It comes in two parts with an Allen wrench in a box, okay? So I get these lamps, I bring them home, it's in like 60 pieces, right? And I put them together, you know, and I felt so butch. I grew a penis right there. Great big old penis. Just walked around with it for a while. Felt like Barbara Stanwyck in the Big Valley. Heath, Nick, Jared, there's a fire in the barn! I wore it, but then it started to itch, so I threw it away. But too much about butch and femme. I don't think many of us do anymore. We just pretend to use those things for the straight people. It makes them feel comfortable, and we have to humor them when we can. So there you go. So I'm in Provincetown, Massachusetts, and I had this very weird moment. I'm in my little cottage, and this great big, huge, scary, hairy spider crawls across the carpet, and I killed it with perfume. No, what does that say about me? You know. And you know, that takes a long time. I'm like, I don't know, now he's just dizzy. He's walking funny. Now he smells like my mom. This year, when I was in Provincetown, the cottage we stayed in actually had a little bug problem, if you will. We had many, many traumas with bugs, and we had two friends come up and stay with us from New York, lesbians, so there you go. And, of course, that's who we hang out with. So my two friends come up from New York, and my best friend Joyce, me, and my girlfriend are sitting in the living room, and a huge, horrible moth thing, you know. I don't know biology, but it was a big bug with wings. Flew in, and they shrieked in fear. So I grabbed my fly swatter, and I struck the fly swatter kill the bug pose, and they went, no, don't kill it! Capture it. Like, we're gonna take it home, train it to do the accounting. So now they're yelling at me and making a big thing about it. You know, why do you want to kill the bug and you should just let it out the door and you're just so mean and you're just so evil and that's really bad karma and it's endangered species. And I'm getting brutalized, and unbeknownst to us, Joyce's girlfriend, who's been upstairs the whole time, comes downstairs, sees the bug and goes, poof. A woman I could love. Thank you.